Welcome to another episode with Lenfantvivant. Today it's all about crap. Crap. Just crap. What is crap? It's something that we face every day. Every now and then. During the day, sometimes also during night, depends on what your habits are. So, how to define crap? Crap is everything that lacks any sense. Crap is everything that comes from mind. You know what I mean, don't you? You better jump off here if you want to hold on to your mind. But if you don't, if you think you've got what it takes, then stay tuned. The mind. We think that we actually don't think. It's cryptic, I know. But let me simplify. We gotta distinguish that thought has nothing to do with thinking. So, to give you more context. All those thoughts that goes around in your mind, like these downloads and whatever other crap, they're just all elusive. And there has never been actually a thinking part in it, because it bypassed that critical ability to observe the crap is. And it's fascinating that mind can do that. And yet, it boringly always just uses the same over and over and over boring mind trick. But what's the trick? Well, imagine it works like a filter. And it has a pole position, so before the critical thinking can actually uncover the mischievous hallucinations it makes up, like these illusions, whatever kind of. Let's not go into details. You know what your mind does, don't you? So, this absolute nonsense comes like a wall in front, and behind there is a critical thinking, where there is actual thinking, but his thoughts try to cloud the view so that it's almost impossible to clearly see all the crap that is going on. But somewhat, there is always this inner voice. And it always tells you, why can't you see that crap you're making up? Why can't you see that fabricated nonsense? And this critical thinking is like, I can strip you anything away at any given moment. And the reason is because there is no fundament. You're just hallucinating. And if there is no fundament, well, obviously, you just slip away very fast. It puts you back into your place where you belong. Nowhere. Nothing. Nada. But there's something beautiful about that nothingness and being back to one's place. It allows you to see clearly in a very calm and peaceful manner, because the crap just got blown off, so there's not much left to either disturb or cloud your seeing. And then you can hear that silence and this absolute peace, and it just mesmerizes you in that moment of total presence, this wonderful awareness, which is always there, some kind, but given all the distractions from mind, awareness cannot truly happen because you're away in your little air castle, which is built on shifting sand. It can't even swim if you would put it on a lake, no matter how many balloons you put underneath, it will always just sink, getting a hole here and there, and the air slowly getting out. Sometimes there is such a harsh wind coming onto one's face, and you sink immediately. So that is mine. That is the crap it is, the crap it fabricates, and the crap it just propagates. We might go into some great storytelling if you want. I'm told to be a great storyteller. And it bores. Really. Anything out of me, like this email that just came in, and I spam, wasting my time, wasting my breath to even speak about, and yet I did. Well, I've got time, that's why I can, and time is something very precious, and yet so. Elusive, since it is not really ticking, it's more sort of like just fading away, and you don't know how much of that time you've got. All you do know is that you're present while time fades, without necessarily a ticking clock or something, because it's very relevant. I mean, relevant in a way that it's relative. And if it's relative, like the art I create, you can play around with it, given perception. But perceptions are so limiting, since you always have to focus on one point, although you've got the entire picture. So it must be limiting. And if you look at the entire picture, why would you bother about the details? I mean, everything speaks to you holistically. That's just what it is. And the moment you get into the details, you lose sight. You lose the comprehension, the seeing of the wholesome from all of that. So, ask your being, can you uncover that self which is only a propagated, illusive image made up by your mind? Can you uncover it? Can you arrive at the here and now? Do you have the guts to look at it when it shows up for what it is? When you can put it back to its place and emerge from that chaos which is yours, only yours. And take a seat into the order, into the clarity, the cleanness, the meticulous attention to all there is. However it is, if you can, you cannot. Both are okay. But perhaps, at least, if you might want to move on with mind, rather than being mindless, and keep your mind full, well, don't bother your surrounding with it. That at least would be loving. Anything else is many things which the speaker does not have any necessity to utter them in very detailed manner. You know exactly what I'm talking about. If you wouldn't, you know it yourself. Then your being might be further away from the accessibility of yours than one could have imagined. And that's something I don't wish to anyone. Because that means your light and your fire has been dimmed to such an extent that it's very, very far away to see how it's smiling at you. Since it's always there burning as long as you're alive. It's the moment you're not anymore and you missed the possibility to ever discover it. Equally, within the total presence, that would be a pity, because it's so beautiful. It is really something, no matter how, through the artistry of words and so many other mediums I use, I doubt ever being somewhat expressing it to such extent that it is anyhow comprehensible. But I try, at least I try to express it the most truthful, unbridled way. So that's all about crap. Crap, crap. And mind. Mindfulness. And the boring repetition that it just represents. Good night, or good morning, or good day. Depending on where you are, where you listen to that. If there's one thing I might give your way, Ask why more than you ask how. And observe what happens if you do so. This is something, any kind of meditation, no matter how exercised one does it, will ever get you closest to your enlightenment. But it's something you gotta explore for yourself, for your own. It's something only you can walk through. No one else will, and no one else can. Through that understanding, that's where evolution starts happening. Au revoir to another episode. Don't forget to give this a 5-star rating, a subscription, a follow, wherever you consume it. Leave a comment. I mean, why not? Either complain about me, write something nice, whatever speaks intuitively to you, both is fine. And if it's mind that speaks, well, then at least I know where to put it back to its place.